أرحيف indeed thank you for Allah we praise him seek his assistance and seek his forgiveness we seek refuge in Allah from the evil promptings of our souls and from our evil actions who is ever Allah guides none can misguide and who is ever Allah leads astray none can guide aright I testify that none had the right to be worshipped except Allah alone having no partner And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his slave and his messenger. Dear brothers and sisters, yesterday we started speaking about the so-called At-Taqseem al-Mawdu'i, which is the substantive interpretation where we are going to give a new look to our reading and receiving Quran so that we are going, inshallah, to divide it into subjects or each time we are given each surah we are classifying it into partitions according to these partitions you are going to be oriented by the whole surah so inshallah you are not going to miss any of the verses due to this or incorrect understanding we have said the first portion we spoke about it yesterday was the classification of Al-Fatiha. We started with Al-Fatiha and yesterday we started talking about its names and I'll not repeat it because I finished it in order to take a longer amount to give you a chance to revise till next week inshallah. So yesterday I finished the names of Al-Fatiha and they were proved to be 10. Okay? And then we came to the dispute concerning al-basmala is al-basmala considered one of the verses of al-fatiha or not and we have said that Sheikh Ibn al-Taymiyyin rahmatullah alayh in arabic rajjaha in arabic the word rajjaha it does not mean that he restrictively said no rajjaha in Arabic means I prefer rajjaha so Sheikh Ibn al-Taymiyyin rajjaha it means he prefers the opinion of not considering the basmala from al-fatiha again Sheikh Ibn al-Taymiyyin rajjaha It means he is with the opinion that Al-Fatiha is not one of the verses of Surah Al-Fatiha. Now, before starting telling the with and against opinions of that and that, I want to clarify one point. This one point is that. Those with considering Basmala is one of the verses There are some points with them. Again, those with consideration of Basmala, one of the verses. So, as it is written in our Medina Mus'haf, and in our Mus'haf, where it is written, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, number one, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, number two, Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, number three, Malik Yawm al-Din, number four, إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين number 5 إهدنا الصراط المستقيم number 6 and number 7 صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين all this they consider it as one verse number 7 this is the classification who consider al-Basmala is one of the 8 verses of al-Fatiha What are the important points to go to regard that? The important point is concerning praying. We are starting our praying by Fatiha. So they are considered, they are considering Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is a verse from the seven verses. As a result of that, as a result of that, they are an they are saying, oh, you please, sister, you mute your microphone, if you please. So, they are saying that Al-Basmala is one of the verses. So, as a result of that, they emphasize on announcing Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim with loud voice during reading Quran if he is Imam. Again, if he is Imam, he is starting his praying Salah by saying Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, raising his voice while pronouncing Al-Fatiha. Okay, never mind, sister, take it easy. And so we are just concerning the recording. That's why. Take it easy, nothing at all. Again, when they are those who considered Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim as the first verse in Al-Fatiha, when he is Imam, he raised his voice in pronunciation of Al-Basmala. Okay? This is number one. He is considering Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is a portion of the Al-Fatiha, of Al-Fatiha, alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, of Al-Fatiha. And so, he emphasized on reading it loudly if he is Imam during his praying. This is number one. And number two, if you don't say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, it is not going to be accepted, your salah. They consider those who are not saying Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim loudly, or if he is alone, considering it one of the verses, so should read it saying Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. If you don't say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in their opinion, your praying is not accepted. Batila. Why? Because you don't pronounce one of the verses of Al-Fatiha, which is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in their opinion, the first verse. You got it? This is the problem in these categories. Those who are emphasizing on Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim as a first verse in Al-Fatiha, they emphasize on pronunciation of it, and if he is Imam, he is pronounced it loudly and not secretly. And number two, if he is considering those not pronouncing Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, their salah is not going to be accepted as they omit one of the verses of the seven verses in their opinion. You got it, sisters? This is the issue of those considering Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim one of the verses. Such group, Shaykh Ibn al-Utaymeen Rajaha, he is with the opposite opinion, which is not to consider Al-Fatiha, not to consider Al-Basmala portion of Al-Fatiha. What is his documents? And Sis Mayad Al-Madi, she is one of his pupils. So she is on the same line of Shaykh Ibn al-Utaymeen. And any opinion before his death, she was doubting, she used to ask him and take his way in thinking. You got it? Why I said to you yesterday, Mayada, opinion, actually it is her opinion from the concept of Shaykh Ibn al-Utaymeen rahmatullah alayhi being his pupil. Okay? Now, what about those considering Al-Fatiha not a portion? Why not a portion? Because four reasons for that. Four reasons for that. Four reasons for that. The first cause, the so-called تناسب مضمون الآيات ومعانيها. Again, I write in Arabic and I'll explain it. تناسب مضمون الآيات ومعانيها. What's the meaning of that? This is the first cause, مضمون, I'm sorry, مضمون, separated from الآيات ومعانيها. What's the meaning of that? مضمون الآيات, if we are speaking about الآيات, if we are speaking about الآيات, if we speak about الآيات, it is related, the word الآيات, الآيات, it is related to two things, to مضمون and معاني. What's the meaning? I'm sorry, مضمون, مضمون and معاني. If we are speaking about the word الآيات versus, what verses mean? What verses mean? It means the subject the verses spoke about, which is مضمون. So مضمون, what it speak about. This is the meaning of مضمون. مضمون is the context, the inside meaning of the verses. So مضمون means the inside meaning or the subject of the verses. Okay? And معاني means meaning, meaning of the words forming the verse. The verse is formed of words. What is the meaning of this word? So I want you, I will write for you an Arabic sentence of Shaykh Ibn al-Taymin. You have to know it and I'll translate it. Shaykh al-Taymin arajjaha. He is with the side. He is sided to the opinion of preferring Basmala is not from the seven verses of Al-Fatiha. I'll try. You are going to write this word, this verse in Arabic. And I translate, what is this word? وَعِلَّةَ ذَلِكَ وَعِلَّةَ ذَلِكَ وَعِلَّةَ ذَلِكَ عَدَمْ مُنَاسَبَةَ الْبَسْمَلَةَ لِآيَاتِ وفواصل الفاتحة. الشيخ ابن العثيمين رحمة الله عليه is with the opinion that بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم is not one of the verses of the فاتحة for this cause. I'll translate it one by word by word. وعلت ذلك علت ذلك means because. But it is a good Arabic word you should to know. علت ذلك, the cause of that. Why Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen is with the opinion that al-Basmala is not one of the verses. علت ذلك, the cause of ذلك. The cause of that, it means the cause of that. عدم مناسبة البسملة. This portion of the sentence عدم مناسبة البسملة. The basmala is not suitable for. Again. وعدم عدم مناسبة البسملة. Not basmala is not suitable for. Again, we are going to combine it together. شيخ ابن العثيمين رجح. He is side to the opinion that basmala isn't a verse from al-Fatiha. The cause of that is the basmala is not suitable for. Isn't suitable for what? For two things. لآيات لآيات ها وفواصل بسملة isn't suitable for لآيات وفواصل الفاتحة. لآيات ها it means two things. It means the it means two things. It means مضمون ومعاني. It means مضمون ومعاني. Again. The why Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen said it isn't suitable? Because of the fact that Basmala isn't suitable for ayat and fawasil. Ayat means the meaning and the inside subject. If we are going, as we are going to say it now, start analyzing the verses of Al-Fatiha, you will find that Basmala is totally away, both in meaning and in construction. If we are going to analyze together, you will find that neither the meaning nor the construction of sentences is suitable for Basmala. Basmala is totally far in meaning and construction with the other verses of Surah Al-Fatiha. You got it, sisters? So, Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen is saying, it isn't one of the verses, cause. It is not suitable, the whole Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, it's not suitable, neither in ayat, which is the context itself and the meaning inside, nor fawasil, and the meaning of fawasil means the ends of the verse. Listen with me. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. If you hear by your earrings, you feel that there is a synergism. There is a synergism in the tone of saying previous verses I told you about it. You feel as if there is, we shouldn't say that for Quran, but as a poet, and we shouldn't say that for Quran. For Quran, for respect, for Holy Quran, we should never ever resemble Quran with poetry. But poetry has certain sound heard and felt by the ear. So that you say it is a good poetry. Okay, we shouldn't say that, but I want to make it near to your mind. Again, sister, the verses of Al-Fatiha other than Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Shaykh Ibn al-Uthaymeen is saying that the main cause Shaykh Ibn al-Uthaymeen depends on is this cause. What is this cause? This cause is that there is no synergism if we put Al-Fatiha, Bismillah. But there is very synergism if we don't put Bismillah. Because if you hear by your sound, you hear the sound by your ear. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Here's the sound. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. So the first three, because they divided into three and in between one verse. So the first three, which is Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Malik Yawm al-Din, you feel as if there is a synergism between them, makes you on hearing feel that they are one, as if a wave. It is like one wave, not interrupted by echo, make it not suitable for the wave to pass softly and smoothly. I don't know, you understand me or not? Do you understand me, sisters? Do you feel the meaning I want you to make it oriented by? Okay. On reading a poem, do you feel in reading it like ordinary text? Again, what is the difference between reading a poem and an ordinary text? Is there a difference? Do you feel a difference between reading or saying a poem and a text? Leave the Quran now. If you are reading a poem and you are reading a text, whether English, in Arabic there is great difference. In Arabic there is great difference. There is as if it is a song. But we shouldn't say that about Quran. In Arabic, great difference between hearing a poem and a normal text. On hearing a poem, you feel as if you are hearing to a song. So in Arabic, there is a great difference between text and a poem. In English, do you feel it, that difference, or you don't feel it? Leave the Quran now. Yes, Alhamdulillah. So the same, ولله المثل الأعلى, because Quran is his words. We shouldn't at all resemble Quran with any poem. We shouldn't. But I am telling that for you in order to make it, I want to make you oriented. In order to make you oriented. But it is impolite. I'm sorry. Again, sisters. In Arabic, there is great difference on hearing a poem and on reading a poem and reading a text. There is great difference in Arabic. And on hearing, you feel yourself as if hearing to a song. In spite there is no music, but the words itself is music-like. The words without music in Arabic. I'm speaking about Arabic poem. In Arabic, if you hear a poem, as if you are hearing words with song, with music, in spite there is no music. It is music-like words. You understand? Let it. Because we shouldn't say that about Quran, or I mean we shouldn't resemble Quran by poem, so we let us make it synergism. Synergism is coaptation of the verses together to make you feel that there is a harmony. You know harmony? You know the word harmony? The word harmony is that I mean by the so-called تناسب مضمون الآيات ومعانيها. If you feel, listen to me with your earring. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم. Again, sister. This synergism in words, you feel there is harmony in the first three verses of Al-Fatiha. It isn't the same if you add the. So, concerning the ayat, ayat means this harmony, this synergism. What is the meaning in Arabic? In Arabic, madmoon wa ma'ani. Madmoon, the meaning, madmoon means the inside construction of the words. Ma'ani, the meaning. So, concerning Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen is saying that it isn't because of the ayat and fawasil. Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen is saying both the construction and the meaning of verses is in harmony and synergism concerning the three verses of Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Malik Yawm al-Din. This harmony is not present if we make it Bismillah Rahman Rahim. It isn't in the same construction nor the meaning. We are going to analyze how the meaning. You got this portion? So, your sister, you write these four sentences. Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen is not considered Al-Basmala from Al-Fatiha because of these four sentences. Number one, تناسب فواصل. تناسب. I will write for you the four sentences in order to miss and then I will analyze. تناسب الآيات والفواصل. This is number one. Number two, تناسب المعاني. Number three, تناسب العدد. Number four, تناسب الفاتحة والخاتمة. I'll analyze everything. Yes, Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen is considering Basmala isn't from the seven verses of Al-Fatiha due to cause, four causes. Number one, the first cause is تناسب الآيات والفواصل. What is the meaning of الآيات والفواصل? الآيات والفواصل is that if you listen to the verses of Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Malik Yawm al-Din, let us be in these three verses, you feel harmony and correlation between the verses, which isn't present if you add Al-Fatiha, Al-Basmala. Basmala isn't in the same harmony and correlation of the verses. Plus Al-Fatiha, concerning the Fawasil, Al-Fatiha is longer. If you hear Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdu, one. Lillahi, two. Rabb, three. Al-Alameen, four. This is the first verse. Malik Yawm al-Din, two. Iyaka na'budu, two. Wa Iyaka nasta'in, two. So the number of the verses or the other cause or the so-called short verses, there is harmony in the verses. There is harmony in the verses. The three are similar. But see, Bismillah, Bismillah too. Bismillah, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. You feel not only longer, but also different context. You got it? Now, This is the first cause. The first cause is تناسب آيات وفواصل. The first cause why Sheikh Ibn al-Uthaymeen considered Bismillah isn't from Al-Fatiha. Okay? Number two, تناسب معاني. What is the meaning of تناسب معاني? Correlation of the meaning. Correlation of the meaning. What's the meaning of... What's the meaning of correlation of the meaning? Al-Fatiha is considered supplication. Al-Fatiha is considered supplication. Al-Fatiha is considered a supplication. Dua. There is etiquette for dua. There is etiquette for dua. What is this etiquette? Huh? To start admiring, praising, glorifying, and then you offer your question. This is the regimen of any supplication. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلِ الْأَعْلَى. If you are going to any person higher than you and you want to ask him something for you, you never go and ask him, give me that. You never do that for ordinary people who are higher rank than you and you want something from them. You should offer first of all some earlier words. By these words, you... So, in ordinary order, you didn't directly ask before praising. So, وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلِ الْأَعْلَى. الدُّعَاء الْفَاتِحَة. There is no doubt that it is the supplication has an etiquette. What is that etiquette concerning... Again, your sister. Al-Fatiha is a supplication. So, being a supplication, you cannot from... So, on asking Allah through a supplication, you should be polite as a slave. So, if you follow Al-Fatiha, you find that Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, praising Allah. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, calling Allah by His most beautiful name. Malik Yawm al-Din, glorifying Allah by being the master of Day of Judgment. So there is correlation in the meaning of offering supplication to Allah preceded by praising, admiring, glorifying Allah. You got it? But if you put Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim first, it isn't a supplication. If you put Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim first, it isn't a supplication. It is. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is said when you want to do anything. Bismillah aqra, Bismillah aktub, Bismillah akul. You put Bismillah in the start of anything you are doing. Asking Allah barakah, grace, and gift to let the... Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, you are saying, by Allah name, I hope this matter will be good. Whatever this matter is, eating, drinking, so Bismillah is a starting word said to anything you are starting. It has nothing to do with the supplication. You are starting and الفاتحة but الفاتحة is a supplication and the best supplication to Allah is sweet Quran. We are trying to be near to Allah by righteous deeds and the best righteous deed. So you are offering your supplication because you want something from Allah. So you start saying, praising, admiring, glorifying. Bismillah is not concerning the meaning, it is not one of these things. Neither it is admiring, nor it is glorifying, nor it is praising. So basmala. Concerning the meaning and the construction is in correlation. It has nothing to do correlated with the other three verses. تناسب معاني means the meaning of the three verses. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين. There is a correlation in again, sister. Concerning concerning the meaning and the context. Again, sister. Concerning the meaning of the first three verses, both. رب نفعنا يا رب نفعنا يا رب بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Again, sister. الشيخ ابن العثيمين said that Basmala is not one of the verses of Al-Fatiha. Why? علة ذلك مناسبة البسملة لآيات عدم مناسبة البسملة لآيات وفواصل الفاتحة. What is the meaning of that? The main cause is that there is no correlation neither in the meaning nor in the construction of al-fatiha of al-basmala and the coming three verses after. Okay, finish this first and I describe it in details. This is the first point. This is the first point why Shaykh Ibn al-Uthaymeen with the opinion saying that رحمتك يا رب رحمتك يا رب لا تشوف أي حال رحمتك. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Let us do more istighfar, begging Allah to let us be allowed for doing what we are trying to do. So again, sister, concerning Shaykh Ibn al-Taymin opinion, he is considering al-fatiha. Number two cause, which is very important, is the hadith of قُسِّمَتِ الصَّلَاةِ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِي. The praying is divided between me and my slave. This is a very strong hadith. The second important cause is hadith قسمت الصلاة بيني وبين عبدي. The praying is divided between me and my slave. Here, listen to me. الحمد لله رب العالمين. Allah is saying, my slave praise me. الرحمن الرحيم. Allah is saying, My slave admire me. Malik Yawm al-Din. Allah is saying, my slave glorify me. These are three verses. After which, the slave is asking Allah. The slave is pronouncing his slavery by saying, oh Allah, you only whom I worship. After which, he started saying another three things. Would you please guide us to Sirat Mustaqim? This is one. That Sirat Mustaqim is that of the pious people. This is number two. And not of that who misguide their way or insist to do without being oriented. You got it? So the middle of these verses should be إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ. So as a supplication, the first three verses is correlated in the form of praising Allah, admiring Allah, glorifying Allah. Okay? And then the slave said, you only Allah whom I worship, and I worship you alone, having no partner. Would you please, what is the supplication of the slave? إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ. You only whom we worship and whom we ask assistance. So, would you please, then Allah said in the hadith, Allah said, this is for my slave and I give him his question. See, if you look to the hadith, you shall find that Allah at that point, after praising Allah, glorifying Allah, admiring Allah, and then he said, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ, Allah is saying, this is between me and my slave. So whatever my slave is going to ask, I'll give him. After which, the slave starts asking, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ. Guide us to the correct way. That correct straight way is the way of the pious people whom you love. Huh? And it is not that of those who are knowing and didn't obey the so-called al-maghdubi alayhim, whom you are and give your anger on. Or, according to that hadith, there is a first three correlated verses which are praising, admiring, glorifying. And in between, the slave is denoting that only Allah whom he is worshipping and whom he asks his assistance, after which he started saying what he wants. إِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ, guide us to the correct way. صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غَيْرِ صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ, those whom you love and give your grace on, I want this way. And then the third is, don't let me with those whom you put them in a stray and you are putting your anger on. Okay? So there is three before and three after and in between إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ. But let us now put the Bismillah first. If we put Bismillah first, we shall say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم. So the middle would be مالك يوم الدين. And okay? Then the other three is الحمد لله الحمد لله الحمد لله. Again, your sister. What are the with evidences that Basmala isn't from the verses of Al-Fatiha? What is the evidences with? The evidences with is four evidences. The first, we have said it, is that the correlation between the meaning and the ends of the verses. The so-called تناسب الآيات وفواصلها. The first is تناسب الآيات وفواصلها. There is no. With the first evidence against being one of the verses of Al-Fatiha is عدم تناسب الآيات وفواصلها. If you look to the verses itself and the ends of the verses, there is no correlation. If we put Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim as the first verse, there is no correlation. This is number one. And number two, the authentic hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no, hadith Qudusi, the holy hadith, قسمت الصلاة بيني. Second evidence, the second evidence is the holy hadith قسمت الصلاة. حديث قسمت الصلاة بيني وبين عبدي, there is no division. If we try to put the Bismillah, if we put the Basmala, there is no division. There is no cooptation. There is no cooptation between the verses, neither in the meaning, nor in the number, nor in the construction. If we put the Basmala, there is neither correlation, there is no correlation, neither in number, nor in meaning, nor in construction. So, the second meaning, the second evidence is hadith al-Qudusi of Rasulullah, of Qusima. The second evidence is the holy hadith Qusima al-Salah bayni wa bayna abdi. There is no Qusima. There is no division. There is no proper division between the two sides of the equation. And number three evidence. تناسب المعاني كمضمون. What's the meaning of that? If we follow the meaning as whole, basmala, a person is putting in the starting of any thing he's doing. It means as a meaning and as a construction, Bismillah is only put for starting any righteous deed. You are starting with Bismillah, as if you are saying, by Allah's name, I hope this righteous deed will be accepted. So you are taking the so-called barakah by starting with Bismillah. Okay? So it has nothing to do with the Fatiha, which is supplication. And from the etiquette of supplication is to start by praising, glorifying, admiring, and then you start give your question. So the first three verses, Alhamdulillah, since Alhamdulillah, it is appraising, admiring and glorifying Allah because He is our Creator, He is our Rabb, He is our Ilah, the most whom we love, the most whom we glorify. So we have to start our supplication by praising Him, admiring Him, glorifying Him. So the first three verses, starting from Alhamdulillah, maintain that. Maintain the admiring, the praising, and the glorifying. And then, interrupted by denoting, by announcing that you are a slave. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. I am your slave, with whom to whom I worship, and to whom only I ask assistance. Accordingly, you start to give your question. What is your question? The best question anybody can ask. What is this best question anybody can ask? Guidance for Hidayah. So comes after which, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Would you please, Allah, guide us to the Sirat Mustaqim, which is the correct, shortest way to Jannah. So it is the highest question a person can ask from Allah. So it should be preceded by glorifying and praising and admiring, which isn't at all if we put Al-Fatiha, Bismillah. So after that, according to this opinion, we should divide the last verse present in the Mus'haf into two verses. If we didn't consider Bismillah is a verse, and we start by Bismillah, by Alhamdulillah, we are going to consider Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen 1, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim 2, Malik Yawm al-Din 3. And then you are denoting that you are a slave of Allah. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين 4. This is number. إهدنا الصراط المستقيم. This is number 5. What is that صراط المستقيم? It is صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. Those whom you love and you give assistance. المغضوب عليهم and الضالين. These are two categories whom Allah dislike. They are similar to each other. They should be with together. But we shouldn't put them with الذين أنعمت عليهم. We should not put المغضوب عليهم. And غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين is another verse. Okay? And then, this will be the third cause. Because I want to finish the four causes before leaving. This is the third cause. Again, sisters, I will revise it in order you not to be. I will revise it in order for you in order not to be. Again, sisters. Okay. Now the causes are. Number one, تناسب الآيات وفواصلها. I finish it. Number So, the important point is that تناسب الآيات وفواصلها. I finish it. تناسب حديث رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم القدسي. I finish it. تناسب المعاني كمضمون. كمضمون means as a subject. There is correlation or not correlation. حبيبتي خلي حد اي حد يسمع انا ما عنديش مشكلة. Again sister. تناسب المعاني. The fourth thing is the beginning of al-Fatiha and the end of al-Fatiha. The beginning of al-Fatiha and the end of al-Fatiha. There is correlation between starting of al-Fatiha and the end of al-Fatiha. Again, sister. The fourth point is the beginning and the end of the correlation. The third, يا إيمان. تناسب عدد. See with me, يا إيمان. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم. مالك يوم الدين. These are three. And. These are three. And then. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. غير المغضوب عليهم. This is another three. And in between, I am praying, I am worshiping Allah alone, having no partner. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. I'm sorry. So, as if it is an equation. Three to the right, three to the left, and in between, إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. So, there is correlated number right to the three right and three four. هيا إيمان. Shall I be transferred to the fourth point because it is in order to finish this to finish this correlated issue. الحمد لله الحمد لله وإياكم يا إيمان وإياكم حبيبة. Now, the fourth thing is the correlation between the starting and the end of the surah. And this issue, which is the fourth, is related to those studying the substantive interpretation. One of its main items is correlation between the starting of the same surah, the starting and the end. And the starting is what? This is one of the main items in substantive interpretation is the correlation between the same surah, its beginning and the end, and the surah and the after surah, and the surah and the before surah. This is this item, only those dealing with substantive interpretation are dealing with this issue. So if we look to this point, which is the correlation between the starting of the Fatiha and the end of the Fatiha, it should be without Bismillah. How? How? Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. See, concerning the construction, Al-Alameen ended by letter Noon. Ended by letter no. يا رب ملناش غيرك ارزقنا يا كريم. See, sister, the most important thing is that الحمد لله رب العالمين. رب العالمين. العالمين is all but Allah. رب العالمين يا sister. العالمين is all but Allah. This العالمين will be one of the three and none other than that, which is the end meaning. Al-alamin will either be those mu'min, believers, sirat al-ladina an'amta alayhim, the believers, and al-maghdubi alayhim, al-dallin. This is the only three categories of al-alamin. And we are going to say, later on, if we correlate al-Fatiha with Surah al-Nas, we are going to say, if we correlate al-Fatiha with Surah al-Nas, see Surah al-Nas, what is saying? قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. And in the end of Surah al-Nas, مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ. So, الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ, الناس means human beings. And al-jinnah means jinn. And jinn and the human beings are only nas. So an-nas is the jinn and the ins. And these are the same are al-alameen. Because al-alameen is other than Allah. Everybody. Other than Allah is from Al-Alameen. And also I'll discuss it to you later on, that this Alameen is both ins and jinn. So the three categories of Surah Al-Nas are jinn and ins. And the jinn and the ins are Alameen. And jinn and ins are either one of the three categories. What's the proof? What is the proof? The proof is in Surah Al-Jinn. وَإِنَّ مِنَّا الْقَاسِطُونَ وَمِنَّا دُونَ ذَلِكَ. So from the jinn, there is believers. And disbelievers and ضالون, because they are behaved without ilm. It is an exceeding point, your sister, but as you can be oriented by the substantive interpretation, that it gives you how there is correlation between the... It correlates, your sister, Al-Fatiha with itself, the beginning and the end, Al-Fatiha with the previous and also al-Fatiha with the al-Baqarah, with Surah al-Baqarah. I'll stop here to continue next time, inshallah. جزاكم الله خيرا بارك الله فيكم سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته